All right, so far we have messed around with some FSL example data. We know how to do this for a single subject, extract independent components, identify things that we're interested in, like it could be noise that we want to filter out, it could be a resting state network that we're really interested in. And now we're going to do this across a large group of subjects. In this case, we're only doing it for 10. Your data set should be larger, but I'm only using 10 because it took a long time to analyze. And once it finally worked, I didn't want to do any more work, so we're going to just do 10 subjects. And then once you do that, you also have your design matrix, you have your contrasts to answer whatever question you want. This is somewhat of a contrived example. We're using some online data. We have control subjects who are, you know, kids who are basically normally functioning, although I've never seen a normally functioning kid, but for all intents and purposes, those kids are normal. Then we have kids who have autism, who've been diagnosed with autism. And let's say that we have a very basic question, which is, we do a resting state scan on controls, autistic population, and then we want to see if their resting state networks are different. We're basically doing a non-paired t-test, two-sample t-test. That's really it. Obviously, you can have a more complex, involved question that's probably more interesting, but we're just going to stick with that for now. And once we work through how you do this for a group of subjects, it should be pretty easy to expand that to however many subjects you have, however many groups that you have, and whatever kind of design that you have, whatever kind of contrast you want to do. All right. So here we do this through the Melodic GUI again, and I'm going to load an FSF file that I already have. I save this as ICA_design. So here I already have my 10 subjects. Okay, I have 5 in the control group, 5 in the autism group, and all I've selected here is their resting state data set. TR is 2.5 that I automatically got filled in. I'm going to delete 2 volumes, high pass filter's fine. I choose whatever I want to call the output directory. Now, as before with that single subject we did a while ago, spatial smoothing I'm going to use on the order of, say, 1 voxel. 3 millimeters, in other words. Bed brain extraction, that's all good. Motion correction, yes, if we have not done it already. And then for registration, again, I just make sure I select the corresponding structural image. So I have these people in the same order where I selected their functional runs. Now I just need to make sure that they also have the same corresponding anatomical run. Right, so if I had them in this order for my functional runs, I should also have them in the same order for my anatomical scans. All right, we're just going to register them to the main structural image, then to the standard space, full search, 12 degrees of freedom. You can go nuts if you want to, do brain boundary registration, do nonlinear stuff. It just takes a long time. I'm not dissuading you from doing that, I haven't done that right here. And then resampling it to 2 millimeters. Awesome. Now, before I said that you should not insult the computers, do not insult the machines, just let it automatically estimate how many independent components to output. That's not actually always a good idea, because you actually can get a lot of components and this thing can end up taking a long, long time. So a good rule of thumb, and there are no hard and fast rules, this is just what I saw from the FSL experts on the message boards, is around 30 components is usually a safe bet. It's a good compromise between underfitting and overfitting without going into hundreds of components and having an analysis that might totally trash your computer. What's different from that single subject analysis is now we're selecting multi-session temporal concatenation, which is the option they recommend you do for resting state data. If we're doing one subject, we're just interested in, say, filtering the stuff out of each subject individually, or just getting components from each individual subject, you would select single session ICA. If you're doing something a little bit more fancy with more task-weighted stuff, you do tensor ICA, but for resting state, multi-session temporal concatenation. And lastly, post-stats is really up to you, how you want to threshold your IC maps, and also if you want to select things like your mat file, a contrast file that you use to make your contrast, for example, an unpaired two-sample t-test, and the associated design matrix. And you'd put that in here. There's one thing I want to mention, which is actually a pretty serious bug. I don't know if they fixed this. I'm using a pretty up-to-date version of FSL. But if you try to do this with, say, these 10 data sets I've done right here, if you try to do this and any one of them has a different amount of volumes than the rest, it's going to crash. Okay, so let's say these five people all have 140 volumes, and this sixth person has 135 volumes. Once it gets to that person, it's going to crash when it starts to do any sort of pre-processing or registration. It's just going to totally die on you. This really threw me for a loop. The way to get around it is you need to go back and basically do the pre-processing for the subjects individually. Or if, say, you know, a bunch of people had a certain number of TRs, and then another whole cluster of people had the same number of TRs, let's say these first five had 140 TRs, and this second group of five had 135 TRs, you could do this first five in a batch at first, and then you could then do this second group also in a batch, and it would be okay. But you just do the pre-processing, motion correction, registration, just do that. And then you would actually have to use Melodic to fix that. So kind of a tangent, I'll actually cover the Melodic command line later. Maybe not in this video, but in another one, just because that's also useful to have. But again, that totally messed me up. It cost me a lot of angst, a lot of time. Didn't know what was going on, couldn't find out from the error logs. But that's basically what's up. But assuming that everybody has the same number of volumes, you're okay. Everything's happy, everything's cool. And you should be able to run this without any hitches. So I also recommend saving this so that you have the design. If you need to reload it and do it again with different parameters, you could go ahead and do that. But assuming you're happy with everything, hit go and proceed to wait a couple of weeks for, not that long, but pretty long time for this thing to run through and calculate everything and output all the components. Okay, I have already done that. So all this stuff is in an output directory. For right now, I think that's enough just to get you started. That's enough to have you concatenate however many subjects you have and to start doing your own independent components analysis estimates. Then the last video, we're just going to kind of round it off, tell you what to look for in these independent components, how to test for significance, and also to run Melodic from the command line.